activity na to. Okay, the video that I uploaded, katong wala siya label no, just the code of the Google Meet ang naa dito sa label. Kuanto siya dito class, mo to siya ang recording sa akong instructions for the activity. So, no need for you to download that, no? Okay.
Ma'am,
so, yes, LJ. Morning.
Excuse si Reynald, ma'am. Reynald Impalmato, kay Gilanat, ma'am.
Oh, I see. Oh, sige, it's okay lang. Wala'y problema kay. Recorded naman ang lesson today.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Daghan gipang hilanta, no? I have also a student as well who wasn't able to join the title hearing of their thesis paper. Kay, kuan, kihilantan pud. So, kamo amping-amping mo ron. Dili ra ba joke ang COVID. I don't know if all are vaccinated. Kami vaccinated per first dose ra pud. Pud na siya kadaog og kuan Delta, no? Simba ko lang. Dili ta mo gawas kay kasi ako I really would much prefer to work at home because when we commute, no, maski asa ra ta mo hiccup and kita maski sa tug halong, we do not really know ang atong mga kadungan kung sila naghalong ba pud sila, di ba? Unya wala po ta kabalo asa sila gikan, no? If nag-sanitize ba sila? Kasi sana to, og amping sa tong kaugalingon per atong kauban, dili, katong nakasakay na to, no? Or na-encounter na to, kung maagto ta, okay, sano and all, kuan di ay, simba ko lang. No? So, kung, you can go outside if only necessary, like you need to buy groceries, or, for example, you need, ang uban din, siya nalang malikayan, no? Kaya magtrabaho, manjud sila, wala po tayo mahimo, ana. Just, you know, protect yourself. Pero, kanang uban nga, mo gawas kay tungod of course mo mula agra I limit lang sa not now kay let us help each other no dili lang for your own safety but for the safety of other people as well even sa inyuhang balay no nga naa may mga vulnerable people sa inyong balay like children who will not get vaccinated no elderly people nga very low ang ilang immune system kay kuyaw na pud kaayo ron I'm not saying pudhang ako an kay kada kung akong usa ka estudyante mang good kana na siya early symptoms ba unya grabe na jud iyang fever mas kuyaw ra bi na karon for example hilanta nun ta mugawas lang ta dito ma-expose ta na we're very vulnerable sad so kung hilanta nun ta because of the weather understand no because kaulan man na ay monsoon or cyclone na jud di ito no pahaway lang sa jud na dili mag sige pulaw and you know drink plenty of vitamins and water kay samot ba dito dali hilantanon kay ang panahon ron gasig ulan-ulan no na may uban hilantanon kay tungod sa panahon diba ka nang mag-ulan init lain kaayo no niya atong lawas sad no mag-adjust or for example na hilantanon because of stress no kana magpulaw because of classwork or kuan siguro i-limit na lang gani na mo ang classwork no? So siguro mag-straight-straight ta synchronous na lang if ever nga stressful ang mga asynchronous activities. Kay, umana, usap po na siya ang kanang pulaw, no? It can weaken the immune system. And then, gawas pa po, no? So, dili juta po hindi, ana. Likay-likay lang sa taron as of now. So, I do hope nga Reynald will maayo na si Reynald, no? Nanya, pahaway lang sa truth. Okay, if dili kayo sa lawas, pwede rin jud, no, si Reynald dili rajud siya mo attend. Basta, thank you, Sal J, for informing me. Basta, inform pala ubang teacher. Kay basin unyag ka na, mangita ba nga, absent na siya sa mga pila ka days, at least makabalo sila nga gihilanat di ay. No, kay ang uban mang good mga estudyante mo, ka na, gihilanat bitaw ko ron. Yeah, your teachers are not mind readers, mang good. How do we know? So, kuan lang, pag pananghid lang jud mo, makasabot ra na ang mga teachers. Anyway, this is recorded. I will really upload every day, no, kada activity lesson, ma-upload man siya ko og recording. So, if you have this fear of missing out, so, FOMO. If you have this fear of missing out, so you don't have to worry, no. You can just catch up with the recording. Okay, let us pray first before we will start our class. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, Amen. Prayer to Saint Rita. Oh, Gloria Saint Rita, you did share in a marvelous manner the sorrowful passion of our Lord Jesus Christ. Give me the grace to suffer in patience the miseries of this life, and be my refuge in all my necessities. Amen. Saint Rita, pray for us in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Dan.
Good morning, Dan.
Morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So welcome to chapter 6, no? Business buying behavior. So today we are going to talk about business markets, business buyer behavior, the business buying process, e-procurement, or like buying on the internet. Okay, most of you know, the people would tend to buy, you know, things on the internet na, because of course for a while lang kasi baka yung iro. Okay, so let's continue. We are going to learn more about e-procurement and, of course, institutional and government markets. Now, institutional government markets are far from, you know, business markets, because when you talk about business markets, it's more on like hotels, big corporations, like restaurants, kana ganing, mupalit sila og supplies because either they're going to resell them or transform them into products. No, para sa anang, sa housekeeping, mapalit yun ta og mga materials for like cleaning the room, no? Or like, for example, like personalized bottles of shampoos, no? Kay buta na to na sa room, and even like towels, di ba? Linen, everything that you can find in the hotel room that has to be procured by the hotel so that to ensure nga nindot ang sulod sa room. Now, in business markets, sing ana na siya, no? Mapalit ta og supplies and materials so that we can transform them into products or para gamiton siya sa to ang mga consumers. So, kailangan man ang paliton, diba? Or they're going to rent it out. So, ang institutional and government markets are different, but they are still part of the business buying behavior because they buy in bulk, and the process of buying, no, their supplies takes a process. Daghan ang mo decide to buy on supplies. Dili ra usa ka tawo ang mo decide nga mo palit ana, etc., etc. No? No, it's not like that. No, it's not how, you know, business buying behavior works. When you talk about business buying behavior, daghan jud, no, because you are using the money of the company. Kung bito itong marag big issue kaayo itong sa natabo sa DOH, no, nga sa COA. Okay, they're using, of course, our taxes, no? Si kami makabash lang may anak kay gatrabaho na gumini. They're using our taxes to procure these materials for health workers, kuno. Hi. And, you know, it has to be discussed with other people if they're going to really buy it, knowing it's expensive, diba? So, you have institutions like the government or hospitals or, for example, like psychiatric wards, no? Those are examples of institutional government markets because they don't really buy materials so that they can sell it, like, you know, like, in the prison, di man yun mo ibaligas mga prisoner, di ba? Sa hospitals, ang uban din, although part mo po na sa bayad mo sa hospital, no, some of that are complementary. You have also, you know, the government itself, mo buying supplies, they are not actually buying supplies to sell. They're buying supplies to use in their operations. So, parsa na sa prison, no, sa prisuhan, they buy big bulks of supplies. Daghan mo decide ana whether to buy supplies or not, o kung sa klase nga supplies paliton, because of course they're going to use that sa ilang mga inmates, no, pakaunon man na nila, tagaan man na nila og like supplies. I don't know if they give fresh clothing, no, they help maintain the facilities where these prisoners are being held, no. And also in the government, no, wherein there are government offices, mapalit man na sila supplies in their office, materials for their projects. They're not really going to buy supplies to sell them, but they're going to use them in their operation. So lahi siya, muna i-separate na to ni siya ang institutional and government market from business market, because si business market is more on buying supplies to sell or to transform into a product. Well, this one is just for their operational use. But still, they are part of the business buying behavior because daghan ang mo decide whether they will buy supplies or not. Maroon ng kalayan sa consumer buying behavior nga. Ikaw ra usa mo decide kay imuha man ang kwarta, ikaw man ang mo gamit. Diba? No, niya. What if sa family ma, makonsider siya business buying behavior? Well, it's still part of consumer buying behavior because you're buying product for your own consumption, not for the consumption of other people. Dira na siya matawag class nga business buying behavior kung mapalit kag supplies because you're going to sell it, not for your own use. Okay, so muna nakalayan sa duha para di mo maglibog. Ang sa government, kay of course, bigger man sila nga institution kaysa sa household, part chapon sila sa business buying behavior, although sila ra may mo gamit ana, di ba? But they are using that to also help serve other people. Ikaw, di man ka mapalit o gatas para iserve sa obang tao, di ba? You're going to buy that because for your own consumption or for the consumption in your family. Ang sa government, dili siya matawag po consumer buying behavior. Kay tungod, mapalit man sila supplies, ilahang gamiton, tinuod na, pero para man na makaservisyo sa uban. So, muna siya ang distinctions nila. So, we are going to learn that one today, no? We're also going to learn about e-procurement. That's where I was cut off, no? Because a lot of businesses would tend to look for suppliers, accredited suppliers online. You cannot simply make a network of suppliers from just, you know, hearsay lang or connections. Mangita siya ka online. Kinsa to ang mga accredited suppliers? Dool ba sila sa imuhang location? And then, if reasonable ba ilang prices, ilang supplies, no? You take, for example, like we have Capilandra who provides us in CSR, no? We have Capilandra that supplies us with materials for photocopying, for like laminating, no? Or kanang, for example, anything na mga printing services that we need to have in our school in order to provide service to the students, ang Capilandra among supplier. Napod may supplier sa kuan sa books, no, like CNE, no, or for example Phoenix, no. So of course you can find those accredited suppliers that, you know, have like quality supplies if you can find them online. So that is why we're also going to include that here. So if you're going to, like, you know, think of a business na, then, you know, this could also be like a helpful topic for you. So let us try to understand first what is business buyer behavior and the difference between business buying behavior. So ang business buyer behavior refers to the buying behavior of the organization that buys goods and services for use in production of other products and services that are sold, rented, or supplied to others. So ang business buyer behavior is the behavior of those people in the company that buy goods and supplies to be used in a production to produce a new supply or product na ibaligya sa uban or ipaabang sa uban. Basta, as long as you are getting profit from, you know, making new products from the supplies that you are getting from suppliers. No, libog kayo, no? So, ato yung butang bangha. Ang business buyer behavior is ang behavior sa manager, ang behavior ni employee, ang behavior ni chief operating officer when picking out supplies from the suppliers na ilahan ng paliton para maghimo sila og bagong product na ilahang ibaligya. Okay? So, muna ang business buyer behavior. While si business buying process is ang proseso. So, ang behavior is ang ilahang murag, behavior ba nga? Okay, before kumupalit, dapat scrutinize pa na ako kung accredited ba ni siya nga supplier. Na ba siya capability to supply 500 kabuok batches? O, muna ang business buyer behavior ka na. Unsa akong pamatasan or ako ang attitude towards buying a certain product for the company so that we can make use of that product to be sold to our customers. While si business buying process is ang proseso in where we determine the products and services nga amo ang paliton, and we can even like choose asa ang alternative dira nga mas barato. Kay na magunay proseso class pagpalit. Proseso ko giingon ako ninyo ato kanina ba nga dili ra diha dayon nga ingon dayon si manager, ginahan man ko mopalit og kuan oy. Nga ko mopalit og sabon para sa amo ang department kay kuan ka na specifically ka lang parehas ako nakitaan dito sa TikTok ay nga kanang mersyag flower shape kay butang na ako siya sa toilet bowl niya kana ika-flush na ko kay naday yung maraglindot ka ayaw nga order mo gawa sa kuan pang sanitize pod siya. And then palit da yun ka diha da yun no order din ka og pila ka boxes. You can't just do that no. In business there's always a process. You can't just say nga I want to buy this Sakura type of soap for our department and then I'll just buy it right away using the company's money. Dili man na ing ana no. Ang ilang proseso is if you want to buy this, you have to make like a proposal. Mangita din kag supplier kinsa amo mo baligya og ing ato nga kind of soap no katong Sakura soap and then you're going to choose among those suppliers at let's say lima ka book suppliers ang go-offer ana nga kind of soap mo pili ka out of the five asa dira ang mas barato og duol and also accredited no kanang daghan na siya og good ratings ba kay tungod nindot ang iyang serbisyo as a supplier ay out of lima ako nakit-an online ma'am usa after himo di kag proposal no nga mo ni siyang supply mo ni siya ang soap nga gusto nako paliton mo ni iyang cost mo ni siya asa paliton mo ni ang mga list of suppliers asa siya dapat pwede mapalit unya ang iyang location and even the background of each supplier okay and then what are the benefits if you are going to buy this kind of soap marsyag proposal ba nga imong i-convince jud ang imong mga managers or you know the COO or the general manager to purchase the item. Okay, once na-compile na nimo ang kanang mga information about the new product that you want to purchase, imo din ang i-present sa kadaghanan, no, the general manager, COO, no, the different department, ipinadira ang marketing and sales, ang purchasing officer, imo na i-present if it's possible to purchase that kind of product. If they agree, you will fill up a purchasing form. Kapoy kayo na sa una class, I remember, no, nag-fill up kog purchase form. Ga from one department to another ga agto jud ko dito magpapirma lang no kay dili man na dawato ni purchasing officer if kulang ang mar pa clearance ba no kulang ang perma sa ako ang purchase form yeah, once man that is already signed the purchasing officer will get the form and then he will start making transactions with the selected supplier to purchase the item so yeah, daghan po na in bulk na mag-discuss din mo og contract nga. Okay, starting from now on, we are going to get you as our official supplier for this kind of soap. You will have a contract wherein your delivery of supplies will be done monthly, ingani nga adlaw every first Monday of the month, and then ingani nga number of supplies ang among gusto i-deliver kada Monday of the month. So yan ano, contract na dayo, no? If you fail to meet ingani, naakay either mohatag kag discount or mo pay kag additional fee. So things like that like marshag memorandum of agreement MOA between the supplier and the hotel or the company baron no made by the purchasing officer. And then once nga that is settled, mo transact na siya, dira pa mo deliver si supplier no or mag-start dayon sila og deliver ana sa item. Sometimes ganito help convince pa jud no the people who are involved in deciding to buy the supplies or not, mag-product demo pa jud na sila class no wherein i-demo na sa representative sa supplier or ang katulong kabaligyaan ni nga product, kung sa mga benefits ni nga product, i-demo na nila. I had one experience also with a product demo no katong. We decided to expand our menu in the bar. So, we decided to include fraps at that time. We're very popular, no? If you think about the popularity of milk, the karon magana ka popular ang frap sa una when I had my OJT so there was a lot of people were really you know asking for a lot of flavors sa frap so mo to nag natoy gi offer ang usa ka supplier nag product demo siya yan nagbuta pa siya dito og like machine that will help you know provide a much more better texture sa frap no and then nag demo din siya yung na product testing, siya testing yung tasting na naman siya kay food good siya good. So, nagtilaw-tilaw din to sila sa mga different fraps nga gihimo and then afterwards, dira na mo decide ayon ang kadaghanan if they will get the products or they will purchase the equipment or not. So, yun ano, very lengthy ang process niya, no? Kay mag-select mala sila no, kung unsa jud ang ilang mga products i-purchase, and then they have to evaluate if it's of good quality, if it's affordable, and of course they have to choose alternative brands. Kay if ever expensive ang first choice, they can have like another choice wherein mas cheaper siya pero the same level of quality. So if you're going to look at the business market, it has a certain process, no, wherein they will buy a certain material, no, or a service. Now, the very beginning is of course the people, no, or the buyers in the business buying process are stimulated by the environment. So unsa man imong other stimuli nga makapa-encourage nila to buy a certain product. No, first is the product itself, no, under marketing stimuli. They have seen recently in a marketing ad nga this kind of company offers personalized shampoo bottles, conditioner, etc., etc., for a bulk price. Kana gani mga gipang gamit nimo sulod sa hotel, like shampoo, toothpaste, soap, conditioner, no, uban dira gani no, lotion, kung labi na kung sweet siya na, padre mga slippers. So they offer personalized items inside the hotel room for a very affordable price. So muna ni ang marketing stimuli, no? Na yung mga products ngayon mong ginapangita nga very affordable based on the price. And when you look at their place, the supplier is just near your hotel. So ay kanilang kay para barato ra ang shipping fee, dili kayo mahal, no, kay within ra sa Cebu province unya 1 hour ra ang biyahe, so barato ra ang shipping fee ani sa to aning ko ano, no. And other than that, the promotion itself, no, nga very enticing jud siya, no, nga ma-encourage ka. That is one way wherein, you know, a business will then decide to seek suppliers because they need that kind of product, no, or nakita nila sa advertisement kanindot siya, so willing sila mo buy anak nga product. Now, that could be one reason why you know, a business is interested in buying a certain product or purchasing a certain product. For sa tong sa example na ko sa Sakura Soap nga nakita niya dito sa kuad TikTok nga very aesthetic kayo, nindot kaayo, so why not, you know, include that in their hotel, no, nga para mas ma-amaze ang mga, you know, mga guests. So mo po na siya number a marketing stimuli or what pushes the consumer, pardon, consumer, no, the business market to actually buy a certain product. So it could be the marketing stimuli. Another is other stimuli is like economic, technological, political, cultural, and competitive. So take for example economic, no, because you're doing so well in your hotel, the kuna jud kaayo mo og na earn, no, so you were able to decide on improving inyo na may mga innovative ga ko ano nga ideas, or you're going to improve the equipment, ay ato ang i-upgrade atong equipment kay dako-dako naman ang ato ang na earn sa hotel, so we're going to upgrade our equipment, or for example ato ang i-renovate ang one of the function halls. Oh, it could be one of the driving forces why you know, the company would push through with looking for suppliers or mopalit sila because they are earning much na, so why not purchase new materials, upgrade our equipment, so palitag bag-o nga equipment, no, para mas moninot pa jud ato ang service. So ana ba, no, parehas ko dira sa kuan sa mo ang school nga, for example daghan ni enroll, so daghan mig na earn nga income, so in one way of upgrading that, upgrade mi sa mga facilities baron, no, na i-add nga system nga mas ma sayon ang transactions, so things like that, diba? So that could be one driving force why a certain business would buy or procure materials or products. Pwede po na technological, pero sa akong giingon sa inyo, no, nga high tech na ron nga kung dili mi mo invest sa money na mo to purchase like an operating system so that we can, you know, have transactions online na. Nga, for example, para sa tong sa inyo ha nga tuition, di ba? I know all students here nakakuan na mo nga sa una mo ang tuition mo dito usa sa school para makabalo mo pila yung balance karon, ni email na lang mo, no, and then sooner or later you're going to have like your enrollment online. So ngano yung anak man na siya, no, because some businesses are forced to upgrade technologically, no, because the world is changing, no? And to be to keep track, or let's say siguro kanang maka patas punta, no? Makakuan punta ba, maka up to date punta, no, sa mga technological advancement. So you really have to invest in technology. So that's why other hotels or companies, they would tend to find supplies, no, not supplies but a service provider that can help set up an operating system. No, so naman na yung mga kuan class, naman na yung mga IT companies we're in, sila ang set up ng mga operating system, no, online na lang tanan ang transactions, and then when you send like a communication to the other department, madawat na yun nila real time. So mga yung ana nga example, no, other stimuli, no. Next is political, no, or even kanang mga policies, no. Take for example COVID-19 pandemic, no. Businesses are required to purchase materials that will protect or at least help sanitize, no, the establishment, no, na ano yung mga barriers ibutang dira, no, acetate barriers, and then na ano ka ng mga temperature, and then also ka ng mo dispense og alcohol, no, sa pamay mga lain, no, daghan, no, na yung mga tracking ko an, and then lain mga laing equipment to help ensure, you know, social distancing, and of course sanitize ang area. So that could be one example why other businesses are also, no, encouraged to purchase, no, a certain equipment or a certain supply because it's a policy, it's a need, no. And even competition, no, can drive a certain business to purchase a supply or a material. Take for example, inyong hotel, abi, no, nakita ninyo nga sa Picas Hotel, daghan kaayo og mga guests. Yung mga naka nga, daghan kay sila guests, no. So, you did like a benchmarking, no, nga wherein nag-visit ka silang hotel. Dito ni mo nakita nga, naa-ada ay sila gym. And then, people went there because they have this kind of facility. No, so, ikaw, in order to compete, also would purchase, you know, sports equipment or sa gym equipment kay para to also level with a competition. No, so these are the things that will stimulate, no, a business to buy a certain kind of product because either they really like the product itself, that's like marketing stimuli, because of the price, because it's near and how it was promoted, or because of other stimuli, no, external factors that help influence them to buy a certain product. It could be because they want to upgrade because they have the funds already, they are growing economically wealthy na, no. Or for example, technological advancements because it's a need, no? The world is changing. There are advancements in technology now, so they have to keep up. Or for example, there are policies, no, that is a requirement, no, kinahanglan nila ibutang sa ilang establishment, so they need to really buy supplies. Or competition, no, because they would really like to also be in level with the competition. That is why they're going to buy supplies, no, that can compete, no, sa urban establishments. So those are just one of the factors that will help stimulate them in buying. Now, once they are stimulated or encouraged to buy, dili na mosulod ang buying organization and buying center before na mahitabo ang buying decision process or to really buy the product. So first, one of the influences that will help, no, push in buying a certain supply are the organizational influences under the buying organization. Like the hotel itself palang daan, no? Like ang nasa upper management, ang tag-iya, or ang CEO, ang COO, ang general manager. So they were influenced by the people in the upper management to buy. Sige, palit mo ani nga ano kay tungod ang uban nga hotels are also, you know, investing their money on this kind of equipment na, so at least so we can compete, or you will buy this and that, no, napo na siya organizational influences, meaning you did not intend to buy this but since it was mandated by the organization where you work or nasa upper management, then you decide to buy the product. Others is also like interpersonal individual influences. So other than, no, the people who are working in your establishment na encourage you to buy that product, it also based on your personal experience. Para sa tong ningingon ang mga supervisor, this is under buying center ha, interpersonal and individual influences. Ingon to ang mga supervisor nga, sa meeting, gi-suggest siya to find an alternative for the brand of, you know, detergent nga they were using in the hotel. The supervisor declined because in his personal experience, out of all the detergents nga iyang gigamit, kani daw kono ang mas easier pud siya to purchase at the same time dali siya makawala og mga stains sa housekeeping department. And then dili man po na dapat mo complain or mo disagree ang ubang departments because the housekeeping department knows this kay sila man mismo ang gatrabaho ang nga department no sa cleaning, most specifically sa paglimpyo pa lang daan. So mo po na siya, no, interpersonal influences can also help you decide in buying because from your own experience you find this product nga maayo ra man and you don't want to replace it, no. So ana, or maybe because you had a very good experience with the supplier. I tried the supplier man good ma'am, although not be ilang mga supplies dugay kay sila mo deliver at the same time kinahanglan na kayo nato dili nato magamit kay wala pa man naabot, no, nya kuti kayo it comes to making transactions. Oh, that could be also one influence why you will not buy or buy a certain product, no, based on your own experience. So with, you know, with the marketing stimuli paired with organizational influences and even your own personal influence, no nga, based on your own experience, that will be the time that you will, you know, decide on buying or not a certain equipment or material. So take for example, you were encouraged to buy the product because of what you've seen in the advertisement and you've seen the product very useful, very practical, and for its price it's affordable and very cheap ang shipping fee because it's near na your location. And then additional influences is your business or the company where you work. No, like the upper management also agrees with you in buying the products. You are more influenced to buy the product because they agree and they would also push you to purchase that kind of product for, you know, to help the business, no, to help improve your services as a business. And based on your own experience, nindot siya nga kind of product because you've tried that before. And kuan pud siya, no? Sa to? Ay, nag-raise lang han. Na ay nag-raise hand or nag-ask. Ay, okay. Sige lang, okay ra. Recorded naman po ni siya nga session. Okay. Tapos na-influence pa rin ka, no? Kaya encourage ka to buy that product. Sige, palit ana kay para at least ma-improve ang inyong services sa hotel, no? Or sa inyong department. And based po sa imuhang experience, maayo man po siya nga product, no? Kaya you've tried that before in your previous nga trabaho. So, that is where you come up with the decision na to buy the product. So, once you already buy the product, so, daghan kisyag proseso, no? Once you decide to buy the product na, and, you know, everyone already agrees to purchase that product or that supply for your business, then after nga ma-purchase din yun, dira na dayon ang buyer response. Buyer response is like your feedback after that you have received the supplies from the supplier and you will have to evaluate if you're going to, you know, make a permanent transaction na jud with this kind of supplier. Maraganig, ato sa sulayan kung maayo ni siya nga supplier kay bag-o para ba ni siya nga supplier. If maayo akong feedback ani, we will make that we will make the supplier as our permanent na nga meaning siya na jud ato ang official supplier ani nga item. Okay, so dire na magawas ang ato ang buyer responses or feedback. So based on the product that we've used, maayo ba siya in terms of quality palandaan and durability? Supplier choice, so the supplier is kuan ba no kanang less hassle ba siya? Maayo ba siya when it comes to, you know, the transactions, dili ba hassle, order quantities? So when you were asked to make the transaction, ang number of orders bang ay muhang gi-require, like for example 500 boxes na meet ba ni supplier, meaning walay kulang. At the same time, they were able also to accept bulk purchases, meaning they have the capacity to even supply you with at least 1,500, 3,000 batches, no, kadang they have the capacity to actually produce bulk orders, no, and delivery terms and times, meaning mumit ba sila sa schedule, on time ba sila, no, mo deliver sa mga supplies, service terms, so pala siya, no, wala ra by hassle ka transact, mumit siya sa unsagig sabutan, no. Nya, kung naa kay mga request like i-alter abi nimo ang kaninga product nga pwede ka nang ilisan lang ang taklob or for example pwede if ato ang i-modify gamay wala ba na sila ko ano dali ra ba kaayo na sila ka transact with regards to that and with regards to payment not only ang price is affordable but you know na like for example when you transact your payment method dili upod siya hassle do they provide like installments, no? Or for example, when it comes to down payment, kay reasonable ba ang down payment nga gi-ask? So mo po na siya imong mga i-consider. So that is actually your feedback or response based on what you decide to buy from the supplier. If maayo gani imong buyer responses and all of these items, then there's a possibility you're going to keep that supplier and you're going to like maintain like a permanent relationship, no, and network with that kind of supplier. That's how the business market works, no, very, very complex. Daghan kay kag ipang consider. You're not just going to think about what you want to purchase for the company, but you also need to ask, you know, other people, no, who are involved in deciding, no, which is ang nasa upper management, the purchasing officer, marketing and sales tanan. Okay, so let's now proceed to market structure and demand. So the structure in the business market class is it's fewer compared to consumer buying behavior. For a while, nasa class ha. Okay. Sorry, nala ko gi tubag nga email kadali kay we have a scheduled defense mungod sa Saturday. Sorry. So let's continue. When you look at the business market compared to consumer market, it's much more bigger compared to the consumer market wherein ikaw raman jud na usually mo palit no kay ikaw man ang mo gamit. Pero in the business market is fewer and larger buyers because not all owns their own business or company, di ba? So very fewer lang ang buyers in the business market. Katulang, of course, no, those who are the company itself, no, or who owns a big company, and they have larger buyers because, of course, they're going to buy in bulk. They're not going to buy like one piece, or for example, they're not going to buy like two boxes only. They're really going to buy like 500, 300 in bulk jud na siya nga daghan kay because it's going to last long. At the same time, ang ilaha na is maghimo guta og new products from these supplies. So we really need all the supplies that we can get. No person ang maghimo ka og kaan. Tapos ta mamaligya ka og like jewelry. Of course you're going to buy like a lot of materials, no? Kana palang materials sa pag-assemble, yung mga beads or gems palang daan, no? Or for example, mo baligya ka o kuan, like ka ng sa pamaylain, dira ha? Sa other businesses, of food, kana, no? Mo baligya ka pagkaon, and how you're going to make like big batches of food, kay muluto kag like pila ka buok na siya nga kaserola puno siya nang pagkaon. You're going to really buy a lot of ingredients labi na if kada adlaw daghag mo kaon sa inyo ha nga restaurant, di ba? So only fewer because there are only a few people who like really own or manage like a big business and larger buyers because they buy in bulk. Geographic concentration, so they focus more on the location because of course, nung ano, location-wise man, kay most of the big businesses are located in rural areas no at the same time at the same time pod class na nakakuan ana sa mga city centered ng mga businesses ang location po sa supplier, they would really not get supplies from a supplier who is living very far, like gikan pa sa abroad no or ang uban pa kay naa sa karon okay naman na kung gikan sa Luzon no, pero ilang mga ginuhon na is ang kind of supply and then pila ka days getting there, so mo po na siya geographic concentration, so the location of the business and its suppliers dapat near, they are really near no, para at least makabarato po sa shipping fee. Kay dili ba na basta-basta class ang pag-transport silang materials kay kana yung mga delivery truck na dagko no. It would sometimes take days if it's really far. Kay musakay pa ba yun ang bark or unsa, no? Di man na siya pareha sa uban nga. Pwede na to i-transport sa aircraft. Dali na kayo maabot. Kay pila naman nakabuok, no? Usara ka bag, usara ka box. Diba? So, dili po na siya yung ana. Drive demand. So, the demand of the business market is either inelastic or fluctuating. May tag inelastic. Masking pila pa na iyang presyo class, daghan na siya punupalit, ana. Because it's really needed. No, an example of an inelastic demand class are like petrol or gasoline, salt, cigarettes are sometimes an elastic demand, no. Kay take for example, no matter how unsa kamahal or kabarato ang gasolina, mupalit man Japan, labi na if we are owning like a vehicle or ko ano kana motorcycle, kay kinahanglan biya punta mo travel unya mura tong means to travel as well, no. So bahalag mahal or barato pa na siya, naa siya pa mo palit. Salt, because there are no substitute sa salt, no. Kung maski mo atong ibutang mo mahal man siguro na ang salt, mura siya pa mo palit because it's like a universal condiment, di ba? Kinanglanon jud siya, no. And even water, no. So mo na siya class, that's inelastic demand. Regardless kung mo taas or mo nobo ang price niya, people would still buy it, no? There was still a demand for that kind of product because it is really needed. So next is fluctuating demand. Fluctuating demand is seasonal, meaning kinahanglan na ko ang mga jackets, mupalit ra ko og jackets og socks during winter or colder days, but when it's hot, I'm not really going to buy them because of course no, dili man siya needed. Or for example, in our industry, in the hospitality and tourism industry, natay seasonal demand or fluctuating demand because there will be a lot of people who will be booking our rooms only if it's sinulog, if there's like a festival, or if it's summer. But if it's not, you know, holidays baron or like a festival, other days ra na siya, very kuana ka, you know, very few ra ang mo check in or mo avail sa tuang services. So that's fluctuating demand. No, kay kung sa ano pud mindset po ni consumer, dili man po ko mo biyahe og layo para mo check in lang ani nga hotel kung wala jud koy agtuan nga nidot like a beach or like a festival nga akong atenan, no. Unya magto naman po ko dira kung wala klase like during the summer, diba? So that's fluctuating, no. Na dili jud all the time daghan ang mo request ani nga product because seasonal ra siya. Then buyer and seller dependency. So of course, the buyer cannot actually buy more supplies and sell them if there is no, you know, seller. Ano, sorry, bali di eh. The buyer cannot actually buy supplies for own consumption if there is no seller. Now, the buyer and seller here are not your consumers, og ikaw as the seller. Ang buyer and seller diri is ang supplier, og ikaw as the business owner. So, ginatawag ka as buyer because ikaw man ang mopalit sa supplies nga imuang himuon as a new product, no? Or supplies na gamito nimo sa imuhang negosyo. So, of course, if wala yung supplier, dili man po ka siguro mubaligya. Asa man po ko og kuan nga wala man yung materials diri sa San Carlos. Di nalang siguro kung magnegosyo og yung ani, no? O yung ana, no? Yeah, si seller po, dili po siya muproduce og a lot of supplies, no, to sell sa buyer if wala po mo palit, di ba? Like, for example, mo supply ko og ingredients sa ing ani nga dish. Pero wala mo ko'y buyer diri kay wala may negosyo nga gabaligya og ing ani nga kind of food. So, wala, no, sayang kaayo, no? So, there is always a dependency between the buyer and the seller. Okay? Next, another structure ni business market is that it has more decision participants. Kato kong giingon kanina no nga daghan kayo og mo decide, dili ra ikaw no ang mo decide nga mo palit sa usa ka product na ay daghan kaayo nga tawo nga mo decide, and it requires more professional purchasing effort. Kay like what I've said before, there is a process, no, meaning meetingan pa na, i-present pa na sa katong mga different department heads, the manager, the purchasing officer, sales and marketing, and then they will have to decide if they will, you know, approve your request to purchase that supply or not, no? And then kuan pud siya no, moagi pa pud siya og kanang process nga mag-sign og form, make transactions, make phone calls, and has to be recorded, no? I-logbook jud siya. So very professional ang purchasing effort, unlike sa consumer buying behavior na ay ako raman ang mupalit, agtan ko tindahan, palit din man na, di pagin ako itali ako expenses, din ako itali ang ako ang kuan kung unsay transaction na tabo, walay tali-tali no kay korban mo gamit. Sa business market dili na siya pwede. Sa business buying behavior, really have to, you know, record every transaction, every purchase. You have to also record, you know, the expenses that you spend on purchasing those supplies. So very professional, no, sa business buying behavior. Okay. Next is types of decision and the decision process. So first is supplier development. Now, again, like what I've mentioned earlier, there is a buyer and seller dependency. So usually ikaw as the business owner, you really rely on your suppliers because your suppliers can make or break your business. If your supplier provides subpar materials or supplies sa imuhang negosyo at ibuta maghimo ka og furniture, unya subpar no, maot kayo nga type of wood, gabok ang gihatag sa imuha, no? Unya lain og baho ang varnish nga kanang imong ibutang to make the furniture more prettier. If ang supplier nimo daan maot muhatag og supplies, sometimes it really affect the quality of your finished product. And in a business class, if you offer like more than one kind of service or product, then you would need like a network of suppliers. Kay na mag-uy uban suppliers class nga usa ra ka type of product ilang i-supply, na uban duhara, and then the things that you need, other things kay mo kinahanglanon wala sa ilaha, so mangita na pugka sa lain nga supplier. So you have like a network of supplier partners. So supplier development is a systematic development where you make network of supplier partners that you depend your supplies so that you can able to resell or use your own products from those supplies. Now, kung mag-o ni siya class, parang ito kong gisulti ninyo, no? Mamili gani mo og supplier class, you have to look online if it's accredited, nindot og reviews, importante na siya. Lantahon po ni mo ang price sa ilahang supply, if it's reasonable kay hinumduman pa na nimo, no, kanang supplies nga gibaligya sa imuha, patungan pa na nimo. Ya kung mahal na ganin ang supplies, patungan pa jud nimo, tendency the customer will either not buy it, no, maybe because it's too expensive. Okay, other than that, again, no, do a background check on your suppliers kay na jud na matabo class nga mailad, no, they would run with your money, or maot ang quality sa supply nga imong nadawat, no, layo ra kaayo sa gipromise sa imuha, or even sa itsura palandaan layo kaayo, no, because like what I've said, the supplies that you'll be getting from the supplier would really affect the quality of your products, no, of your services that you provide. Okay, so this is the model of business buyer behavior. I think this is the last one before we will end our class this morning. So this is the very similar to the business market na process. So these are just one of the few things that of course will influence, you know, the buyer to purchase a material. It could be like environmental factors, organizational factors, like it's your procedure or your policy in the hotel to always purchase this kind of supply. Like dapat jud ma mo palit jud ta mo purchase jud ta og ang ani nga kind of supply. So nga naman kay it's a policy in our business or in our company that we need to buy this kind of supply. Kaya gina-appeal nila sa ilahang like complimentary gift basket or complimentary gift. Kaya parang matingal ka, mo palit man sila daghang kagiratan baskets, ma'am. Ano, because policy mong guna na to, ma'am, nga, kada biya ni guest, taga-andro na sila like complimentary gift basket. Oh, that could be like, you know, one of the motivations why a buyer would buy a certain supply, di ba? Interpersonal, no, like your own experiences, your own characteristics baron, and individual, no, which is your age, immersive demographic kind of ano nga, your age, your income, education, job position, personality, and risk attitudes. To put it simply, all of these four are just one of the factors, no, or one of the many factors that will really influence a buyer to choose or decide to purchase a certain kind of material, supply, equipment, or ingredient, anything that he needs to make a new product or i-resell niya sa iyang customer. Actually, very similar naman isa kung explain ani. I'm sorry. Ani siya. Maka ng mga influences in the business buying behavior. So we'll continue with major types of buying situations next meeting. This is actually a different kind of, you know, situation we're in. Namagoy times class nga when we buy from our suppliers, pwede mong good siya ma-remodel, pwede siya ma-modify, pwede ma-ilisan, no? Kay ginahan mo i-customize ni mo siya na may uban nga mga suppliers gadawat og mga customizations, no? I remember a lot, no, kay katong wala ko ilingaw sa una pag pandemic, pag start sa pandemic, kailan tarjo ko sa kanang mga suppliers, baka na curious ko, naghan nanggawas ng mga baligya dili sa San Carlos, like shoes and like jewelry, asam sa tigkuan yung mga supply niya. Kaya naging sasige na ako, huwag ka na pangita-pangita, kita ko usag mga buy bulk niya, kasi barato gay, tag-singkura ang chain, niya, buy bulk na siya ibaligya, o niya, napayoban nga ka na, they also do like remodifications, like, for example, ako, maligya abi ko og shoes. Unya na sila package nga 10 pairs of shoes. Unya, pwede na i-engrave ang imuhang brand name sa sole. So, dira. Og ang box, like for example, ang pangalan sa imong business is Christian. Unya, ibutang dira sa name sa box ni mo kay pangalan sa imong business and even okay. Sa...
Uy! Hala!
Kindly mute your microphone. Kinsa to nga microphone? Yes, Kylie. Hello? Ay, okay, see. Let's proceed. So, naman po'y uban, no nga, maalaw sila, ana, no nga, for example, if you're going to pay, yung ani nga amount, abi, no, like, 3,500. So, you'll be getting, like, 3 pairs of sandals, and then, we can customize, like, the box, and even, we can engrave the name of your brand in the shoe. So, ikaw, like, mubaligya ka og ka ng mga, uso may aron ka ng mga flats, di ba, nga cute ka, ayaw lang lain, o color, o niya. Pwede niyo ma-engrave ang pangalan sa iyong business, di ra. Like, for example, Krisha ang name sa brand sa iyong shoes, and then pwede po sa box, no? So, pwede mo, ano, then napay ka ng appeal sa inclusions kay, you know, mga paper bag, ana, no? So, marag na kay imong own startup nga mini business ba? So, muna yung mga uso sa una ka itong pandemic, kay uso naman online selling ato, no, niya, hantod karon. So, there are actually suppliers that can do that. They can really modify products in bulk based on sa imong preferences. So, we will elaborate on that next meeting. Okay, yung mga different buying situations. Dili mo ko na siya ma-inject. Anong pwede ang modified rebuy, na kay mga list-ilisan, customize ba nimo? Okay, so that ends our discussion. Kuan pa man siya, no? Kanang introduction na sa business buying behavior. So we will just continue that one on Tuesday. So we'll have a synchronous class lang before ta mag-exam next week. Any questions before you will end? Okay, so thank you so much, everyone. Now, you don't have any activities lang ha. Just focus on the activity that I posted last Tuesday. Deadline of that will be next week, Tuesday, Japan. I think 12 noon man siguro to. Since you do not have any questions na, so let us pray. Open sa nako ang prayer. Yes, Kylie. Or ang baby ni mo nga kuyog ang morning raisahan.
Na, okay ra, okay ra. Ka nam.
Ah, sige lang, okay ra.
Sorry
kita na ko tong, oh, okay ra. Kita na ko tong bata nga imuhang nasabak nga basta ka tong baby garo ang ning kuan. Sige lang.
Mangudap.
Ah, sige sige. Okay ra dai, okay ra. Igsuon mo ni ko ay ni Kim. Personal mo pangal adult do mo pangalan. Ah, okay. Modi ay kay parehas mo og last name. Nya yeah, K pa jud so abi na kog igsuon kay Kylie og Kim man. Or Kardashian. Okay, so let us pray. Everyone, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Oracia imperata for protection against COVID-19. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need. Seek your protection against the COVID-19 virus that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people, tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all, and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin, amen. Our Lady, health of the sick, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Raphael the Archangel, pray for us. San Roque, pray for us. San Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. San Pedro Calungsod, pray for us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Okay. Once again, thank you so much, everyone, for joining me for today's class. Okay, so thank you, everyone. See
thank you.
See you next week.
Thank you,
everyone.
Bye, Dan.
Thank you, Dan.
Bye, everyone. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye, Dan.
Bye, everyone. Bye,